Welcome back to Weekend Out. My name is Gaurav. नाम तो सुना होगा. अब ब्रेक पे जाने से पहले I had asked you, did you know which country is the highest consumer of gold in the world? A lot of you may have thought the UAE, Dubai, but that's not the right answer. The right answer is India. That's right. India is the highest consumer of gold. Of course, a lot of gold is sold through Dubai, and these sales are encouraging a lot of new entrants to come into this market. The latest entrant in this market of the UAE is an Indian brand called Bhima Jewelers. They recently launched and entered the UAE. Jewelry makes a lasting fashion statement in today's world. It adds charm, glamour, and glitz to the personality and makes you feel confident with the perfect look. Dubai is known for keeping the finest jewelry from all over the world. But to get your dream design, one looks for the best jewelry in town. And at times, this search can get very difficult. Bhima Jewelers, an Indian jewelry company, have all the best designs and materials of jewelry in Dubai.
Bhima was founded by my grandfather, Mr. Bhima Bhatter, way back in 1925 in a place called Alleppey. And he set the benchmark for quality in terms of purity when there was no hallmarking.
Bhima Jewelers are specialized in making remarkable jewelry in gold, platinum, silver and diamonds. The rich collection of jewelry is appealing to people belonging to various walks of life. Bhima Jewelers are part of the Indian company Bhima Groups that has maintained its reputation for more than 50 years. The jewelers started their original work with silver and later on involved other metals as well.
Now Bhima is here. So we have a lot of customers who have already been existing customers who are based out of Dubai who are already buying from us back home. So, you know, that I'm sure that we have a very decent market share here. We're confident that within no time, you know, we'll be able to have a good market share in UAE.
Their jewelry is known for following the latest trends in the market and presents the various collections by following a specific theme. It's human tendency to compare everything that you're about to buy, and I think that's the reason why the concept of exhibitions has become so popular. But did you know the first ever World Expo, which happened in 1851 in London, was called the Great Exhibition? So that's how old the culture of exhibitions is. Of course, the next big exhibition or the big Expo 2020 is happening in Dubai. But before that, there are a lot of these smaller exhibitions that keep happening that cater to a much smaller audience. And one such exhibition happened in Dubai. It was called En Vogue. En Vogue is back this year, welcoming Dubai's signature hot summer months with a sizzling collection of super cool couture, fashion and accessories. The edition was titled Summer Chic, and it showcased the regulars alongside a selection of new designers from around the world, namely Kunal Tanna, Himal Kaul and many others.
This is my second experience here in Dubai. I love Dubai and it's a beautiful city. It's a very inspiring city. It's a very fashion forward city. And En Vogue has been an excellent platform for us to showcase our work. So it's super exciting. It's fun.
Chic fabrics, floral patterns, glitz and glamour, fresh cuts, mix and match accessories. These sum up the trend of this year's edition of En Vogue. Women were spoiled for choice as kaftans in billowing chiffons, sporting trendy New York images, eclectic waistcoats in imperial jewel prints, super cool skirts with aesthetically bold yet feminine tops, asymmetric dresses and corsets were merged well with coy shararas, kurtis and saris with compelling jewelry, shoes and bags to complete the look.
Actually, I was very pleasantly surprised. The market is completely different, but I've really enjoyed meeting the new clientele. They're really, really encouraging of local designers, which is quite refreshing, and I'm really happy to be here.
Well, En Vogue's been like good 6-7 seasons old now. Vasimi's been apart since the last about 3-4 seasons. It feels much better. Every day, every season just gets better.
We didn't want to be just another exhibition. We wanted it to be a total lifestyle experience for women. We're very, very happy with the turnout, and we've always wanted to do things, take things few notches higher. We're growing and we've got lots of ideas in the pipeline. And hopefully in the next season, we shall incorporate those as well.
It's time for us to take a short break, and I love this break because when we come back after this one, you and I are going to have a great meal together.